Okay. So first of all, who are the composition? I will write down, it is present also in my lectures about first year, so it's not advanced topic, but I will write down very synthetically. I will not do the proof, because the proof is quite simple. Let us say that you start in C. And you have some vectors, D, 1, D, M. You want to produce, this is in, output. You want some W1, WK, such that the span of W1, WK is equal to the span of D1, DM. Then you can also have that WI is orthogonal to WJ if I is different from J. And if you want, you can also have the length of each WI is 1. Okay? So in these vectors are also orthogonal, and you can normalize them. You can have orthogonal. This is Gram Smith. It's a little bit different from in textbooks. Why? Because you can see in textbooks, usually they assume that these are independent, and so K will be equal to 1. But what we are doing, I will just write down the shortcut. Then, first we are in then you set sum h equal to 0. Then you do one. I'm doing here? What I'm doing here? I'm subtracting from BI the projection over the span of W1, W2, WI minus 1. In the first run, you will not get anything here because J is, has to go from 1 to 0. And because I have 1. So the first run will go. And then you will see that now we will find W1, W2, and so on. Now, then you have to perform a check. Than the usual, not much difference, but it's a little bit better than the usual transit procedure because you are not to assume that it's undependent. What happens if one vector is dependent from the previous one? Then when you will, this is the projection, when you will project on the previous, the span of the previous vectors, you will get zero. You will not see. Okay? So, let us thing now. Let us say now that, for example, assume that M is less than N. Of course, K is less than or equal to 1. Because we started from M vectors, if we discuss something, we will go down. Okay? What we will get? Let us take one W1. Hello, let us take these vectors in these are vectors in Cn. Okay? These are vectors in Cn. Let us take W1, Wk. And then let us complete and assume that this W, they are orthogonal this was two orthogonal. And let us complete these vectors with some an orthonormal base of Cn. You can put some other vectors. You can choose the next vector orthogonal to all vectors before and so on. Can. Okay. So this is a unitary matrix. Why? Not unitary. Yes. So the transpose is equal to two things. Unitary. Star H QH. Unitary matrix. Because the base is orthogonal. Right? Columns are up. So what is A? A, if I have C, N times M matrix, I will take V1 equal to the first column, Vn equal to last column. Okay? But how can I recover A? Matrix A. So the first column, I can multiply Q by a matrix. This matrix is N times N. This is N times N. Okay? How this matrix is done? So V1, letter is zero, and then you can put here zero. Why? Because when you multiply the first column of the product will be given by multiplication of rows with the first column here. If you put first column zero, here you get zero in the multiplication. It is clear. Okay? And if V1 is not zero, then W1 is equal to V1, and then you have to normalize. It is multiplying by a positive constant. So we get some positive constant, let us say C1. C1 so is bigger than or equal to zero. Okay? Okay. You can even choose a negative constant, but when you normalize, you just have to choose the positive constant. So we cannot exclude the case that C1 is zero, because if because why? Because if this here you are C1, when you multiply, what you get? W1. Okay. Times C1, so V1. Okay. By the same argument, here you will have a matrix diagonal C1, C2, Cn, and here you are all zeros. For simplicity, let us assume that all these vectors are independent. That if all these vectors are independent, all these constant can be chosen positive. Why? The second is V2 is the linear combination. First, W1 and W2, if they came from linear combination of W2 comes from the linear combination of V2 and W1. W3 comes from the linear combination of V3 and W1 and W2, and so on. This means, it can be proved very easily, that in order to get first V1 and V2, you have to have linear combination of W1 and W2, V1, V2, V3, linear combination of W1, W2, W3, and so on. So it means that when I multiply here there are coefficients different from zeros only in this upper triangle. Here you can have everything you want. It depends on this position. But after, you have zeros. Why? For example, let us say that you have something A, R1, 2 here. When you multiply here, what you get? You will get R1, 2 that will multiply the first column, and C2 that multiplies the second one. So you will get a linear combination of first two. If you put the right coefficients there, you get what you want, so V2, and so on. What happens if some of these, let us see, that you have five vectors of length 7, okay? Then, what happens if you get that you have only three vectors independent? Let us say the first, the second, then the third is dependent from the first two, and then the fourth. Then you will get something like this, C1, the second you will get C2, something here. Then all zeros here. The third will be dependent. What will it mean? That you will have something here, and the third constant will be zero. Because when you will get this, this will be discarded. Then you will have
63, but you know, it is not on the diagonal. Why? Not on the diagonal. Because the fourth is dependent from the first two. And then you will get the fifth, we told that is dependent on the first three. You get matrix like this. But in any case, this is diagonal. And all coefficients on the diagonal are non-negative. First two are positive, all others are zero. But you can even say that this C3 can be taken as. But you cannot say anything about what where I put X. Okay? So you got this decomposition. This is so-called QR decomposition, because this is Q, that is unit, and this is R, that is rectangle. The same is true if M is bigger than N. But if M is bigger than N, you have a little bit different. A little bit different, because in this case, if M is bigger than N, then Q is M by N, and R now is M by N. It is still true that in this corner you have zero, but here you don't have just triangle, but you have this trapezoidal shape where it can be decomposed. By the same. Yeah. Okay, this is first. Then, we told you already that this is not very good method in matter, because it's not. So we want to see the most important case is this one. We want to see, at least in this case, the other it is just similar, but we want to see this case. If the same can be done, if the same can be done with the household matrices. You remember what is household matrices? I have this W, any vector in CN, a household matrix HW, it was the identity, minus twice RN. Household I want to know R. Yeah, good. W. So this is carbon. Okay? And which was the if you put here multiply by W, you remember this was W minus twice W, because this is 3. And so W becomes minus W. This W, linear application, sends W minus associated to this matrix, sends W minus W. If you remember, if some is orthogonal to W, if I multiply, this type just stays the same, because if I take V here, IV is V and the W transpose V is 0. So this, you remember? remember that this Hausdorff matrix just reflects this vector, and the in the orthogonal space does nothing. Okay? So this is an isometry. So this matrix automatically is orthogonal matrix. We are in R. Is orthogonal because it okay. If you apply this is symmetric matrix, and if you apply it twice, multiply twice, you get that. If you multiply twice, this goes back to W and everything stay the same. It's clear. Okay. So I want to do I will work one example, it would be better. In order to, because we already proved that we have this QR decomposition in the other window. We just want to understand why we can do this via Hausdorff matrix. Okay? Let us say that I have this vectors 1, 2, minus 1, 1, 0, 1, and
we take the difference. The difference, what is this? Is one vector that is orthogonal to this. In R3, this vector will be orthogonal to a place, a plane. But what we can build? We can build other order methods that we build this plane, this other plane, say the same, and just want to send this into there. So we have to take the other order methods, stop the difference. The half the difference. So, now, we take, how is this method? This is I minus twice, I have two, and W is this, and then we have to compute this. Let us compute W1, that was, this is 1.5. So this is square root of 2 minus 1 squared. No, the opposite. This is 0 minus 1. Thank you.
multiply 1/4 is cancelled, and so you get here square root of 2 minus 1. So if I divide by square root of 2 minus 1, I will get square root of 2 minus 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1 over square root of 2, plus 1 square root of 2 minus 1. Should be like this. We have to sum up. So 1 minus 1. Here we have 1 over square root of 2. Then 0. Then minus 1 over square root of 2. Then you have 0, 1, 0. And then you have 1 over square root of 2, 0. This is square root of 2 plus 1, half. This one. Because this times this is not. It's just this. Multiply by this above and below. Difference of squares is 1. So square root of 2 plus 1. Now, so minus 1 plus 1 is 0, and here we have minus 1 over square root of 2. Is it orthogonal? Wait a moment. It is not orthogonal, because I made some mistake somewhere. Because these are not orthogonal. Should be one. I should have should be one of these two should be plus. Maybe this is plus. No. Symmetrically symmetric. So this, I don't know why this should be, here should be plus. So symmetrically symmetric. Okay, okay, then you check. We can check if it is true, because now, let us say that this is H1. Now, H1 square root of 2, 0, 0. And here we have L. What does, you have 1, times square root of 2, 0, 0, and is equal to 1, 0, 1, and then you get other things. You see? 1 plus 0 plus 0, 0 plus 0 plus 0, 1 plus 0 plus 0. So, this is, okay, you can see that the idea is simple. It's very simple. Just work out, it takes
a little bit, but for example, if you program a computer, okay? Of course, now, if I multiply by H1, I got this adjusted, and here we get some new vectors, okay? So the program, I want to multiply these new vectors. Let us say that I have here a new vector I will call W2, okay? Actually, I don't care. I want W2 for me as one coordinate less. Then I want to multiply. Why? Because when I multiply, I want to obtain something here. Here I don't care. I want to obtain C2. And then I want to obtain here C3, and then I don't care. So what I have to do? I have to multiply. Okay, I will erase this. I have to multiply, I will write down, this is the example, it's not important. So I will get 1 over 1, I have W2, then I have, I locate for this two, okay? This was I already check this. If now I multiply, let us say that I multiply a matrix 1 0 0 0 0 0, what will this will do? This will preserve the first column in the product. When I multiply here, when you have, wait, why? Yes, because the first column is the multiplication of I want to send in order to preserve the first column here, I have to multiply on the other side. Some matrix. metodo che one in, has to go to, sorry, has to go to the second vector of should be three. Okay? And I want the H2 of W1 of A1 is A1. Okay? So, what I want that A1 stays the same. Okay? So, A1 should be A1 is 1 minute. So, this W2 has to go to A2, but W2, I want to choose W2 in order that the same length of A2, but the difference has to be orthogonal to A1. Why? Because if the difference is orthogonal to A1, A1 is orthogonal to this difference, and when I apply H2 to A1, A1 stays the same. Okay? Is it possible? W2, I want just to put something here and then C2. Is it possible sorry, this is the A, I made mistakes here in W2. H1. This vector was x c1 plus c2 c2. So this vector was e1 was going to a1. So this is x a1 plus c2 h1 of c2. Okay? So E1 was sent to A1. E2 is orthogonal to E2, can be decomposed to A1, sorry, X A1
is the same length of E1. So E2, okay, I took the E1 axis in this direction, E2 axis in this direction, but it's not important. So what I want to say is that the image of this what was stated was that the direction half sum of x1 and a1. So this can be decomposed in some piece that is stable and some piece that will get reflected. Okay? So yeah, I have this vector here is W2 is let us call this I want that this will go to A. But I want still that this will present A1. So now, let us draw a picture of it. I have A1. If I want to present A1, I want that W2 will be here. If I may. Okay. W2 is H2 of A2. Because H2, if applied twice, is vector. So, A1 I know, A2 I know. I want W2 enough. So by multiplication of the first household of magnets, I took A1 and I sent it to XA1. Now I want to preserve this direction. The second H2 should not touch this direction. Okay? So should have some and should take some vector W2 in R3 into A2 multiplied into R2 A2. But W2 I want to have this in order that the orthogonal and the A2, what is W2? W2 has to be H2 or W2 is A2. H1 can be done. This can be done. So I can multiply by a second matrix. The first step we did. It's not useful to lose time here. The second can be multiplied by three matrices in this case. H2, H2, H1. The first. And then you have C1, C2, C3 in this case. In this case, because the matrix was 3 by 3. And then you will get A. Okay? So the first matrix adjusts the first column. The second matrix is done like this. H2. Is 1 0 0 0 0, and here you have another household matrix 2 by 2. Why exactly can be done now? I miss, but it can be done. H prime and two. The third will be 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 and some C 3 and some and 1. No, the third term will be just 1. But in any case, can be we just do just first step, but we can have for any matrix A, C, M times M, M bigger than M, we can have that we can write H1, H2, HR. The maximum number here is R less than or equal to N times matrix less than N, and you have a matrix R here, and you can recover the matrix A. Can be done. So you will get the same decomposition, but only using household matrix. Okay. What I want to see now is how to apply this to our. You remember, we had the system AX equal to B, and we wanted to find the least square solution. And the least square solution was such that AX is equal to AH. Okay? This is equivalent to AX equal to BC. You remember? So it's not that this has only one solution. There was the solution of minimum length. Then, if A has this decomposition, which we proved already in one way, but we can, this can be done also with household matrices. What is AH? AH is RH R. Okay? RH QH. So here you have RH QH Q R. This is RH. R is equal to R X equal to RH B. RH QH. RH. Why? Because Q R H and Q, they cancel. Because Q is unitary. But then you can even cancel this. Why? When you can cancel this? You remember that R is N times N. So RH is N times N. When you can cancel this, you will have that RH should have a left inner. But when you multiply RH to the left, the only square matrix can be N by N. So, this implies that N should be less than or equal to N. And the rank of A should be N. In this case, you can cancel this. Why? Because there is left inverse. Okay? Right, so you multiply on the left by left inverse of this, and then this. And then you will get, if you knew the
In this case, this is called QR normalized composition. And in this case, you see that the system becomes much more simple, much simpler. Why? Because R is triangular matrix, if you remember. Okay, this is a vector. Okay. Not triangle or trapezoid. Because the number of variables I thought there was n by n. So I put the number of variables on okay, coherent with the QR decomposition, but not when we have a system, usually we call n the number of variables. In this case, we have n variables, and the number of data are n. Since n is less than m, we can have more than one solution. So we have less variables than, of course, because otherwise you should have only one solution. Okay, then let us now examine one application let us say that I have some couples xi way r and I ranges from 1 to n. So I have x1 way 1, x2 way 2, x3. I have many points measured on the plane. I want to find the so-called least square the straight line such that the sum of the squares of the difference between the value computed the straight line minus the actual at xi and way I, this sum of squares is mean. It's called the best mean approximation. So we want to find two parameters, let us say A and B. What do we want to minimize? We want to minimize the sum from E equal 1 to N of way I minus A x I plus B I squared. We want to minimize this over
AB in Austria.
The minimum doesn't exist because this is when A and B goes to plus infinity, this goes to plus infinity. Okay? And so, what we can do? Of course, we can, so here is B. Not here. We want, we can take the only minimum, there is only one minimum because this can be seen that this is convex function. And we can just take the derivative with respect to B, the derivative with respect to A, and equal to G. If we take the derivative, so this is F A min A B, F of A B. If we take the derivative with respect to B of this F, and what is this? This is twice the sum, actually minus 2, the sum of weight I. Minus xi plus so you will get if this is zero you will get so minus 2 is not important you will get the sum of weight I is equal to the sum of A xi plus B. But if you divide B summed up m times is just B times n. If you divide by n, if you will get the average of weight is equal to A times the average of X plus B. So this is the first condition. And this you know very well that you have to like this. And this is the first equation. The second equation. If you now you have to take the derivative with respect to A, so you will have the sum E I equal 1 to M minus 2. Now you have X I times with I minus A X I. Okay? So, and let us so this has to be equal to zero. Okay? Because when you take the derivative with respect to A, you get this.
I equal 1 to n. Xi weight I is equal to sum I equal 1 to n. A x I squared plus B sum in order to this can be expressed as in more simply because we can what I want to know that these conditions are the same if what I put here I want a matrix A. What is this matrix A? This matrix A is I want to A B. Okay? I want to put X1 1, X2 1, XM 1. And I want that this will be equal to way 1, way n. Why? Because this, when I multiply, I want that ax1 plus b1 plus b is equal to way 1. It's not possible, because these are only two parameters. These are m conditions, many. But I want that this will be satisfied in the least square sense. So, what I have to do, I have, first of all, I have to KH A A B this should be A H vector wait. Okay, this is the system. This is now a 2x2 system. And all I want that here I have this has rank 2. If this has rank 2, this has unique solution. If now we will write down this, we will, so H actually is A plus 2, because we are in R2. And this is A plus 2. Let us write down the equation. Okay. What is AT? AT is X1, XM, 1, 1, 1, X1, XM, 1, 1, AB, and this should be equal to X1, XM, 1, 1, 1. Way one.
then you see that the second here, this is sum way one, way I one, and this is sum of x, y, way one. Okay? Here, just multiply. The second element is the sum of this. The first element is the scalar product. Okay, so you see, these are what we got from the first hand of this equation. What do we get on the other side? In order to have what we get on the other side, we have to have this multiplication. This multiplication is the norm of x squared. Then we have the sum of xi. Sum of xi. And then n. N. Okay? So, and then you have a. So, you see that here you have a times the sum of this plus mb, a times the sum of this plus a mb equal to this. This is the equation corresponding to the second rule. And on the first row, what you have? A times the norm of x squared plus b times the sum of xi is equal to this guy. Okay? If we want to reason in probability terms, we can express this equation in some better way, taking into account the variance of x and y. But this is not my aim now. So you can see that in order to have this, just is that it is just the solution of the system A x equal to way A, the way A is this matrix for these two parameters equal to way, where solution is to be taken in the sense of the least squares, in the sense of several units. Okay? And it's unique. It's unique because this matrix, I wonder it has where it has rank 2. What if I want to find, you know, take the same data. Let us say that you have a distribution like this. Then you have like this. It does not seem to correct to approximate this with a linear, to find the linear correlation. It seems to, for example, in this case, seems natural. Okay, this is dangerous. But it seems natural to us, for example, quadratic. Okay? So we have that way I is correlated to a quadratic function of x. Okay? Then,
can do. It is simple.
So, quadratic function, how it is written? Ax squared plus bx plus c. So what you have to do? You have to do like this. And you have to consider this system. Of course, this system cannot be solvable in general, but you have to solve it in the sense of pseudo-inverse. And what you will find? You will find ABC that will give you the parabola. Parabola that minimizes the sum of the squares of the difference between the data and the computer function at xi using parabola. So you see that it's very simple. But you could say, but if we do like this, we know that when we solve, so what we have to do? This is A, and then we have A transpose A, X equals to A transpose B. This we have to do. And this system is solvable. And why this has only one solution? Let us see. This is 3 by 3. This is not the two halves, but this is 3 by 3, and it is measurable. It is sufficient that it has rank 3, and so it is sufficient that this has rank 3. Remember, if this has rank 3, AHA has the same rank. And or H transpose B is the same because we are on the in the real numbers. So but it is true that this has rank 3 as soon as we have 3 different X here. It is true because as soon as you measure the data at 3 different points, the minor correspondent minor is the so-called van der Monde matrix, and it has determinant different from zero. Okay, what is it, van der Monde matrix? A matrix like this. You have, for example, 3 by 3. You have 1 x 1 x 1 squared, 1 x 2 x 2 squared. 1 x 3 x 3 squared. What is the determinant of this? Determinant of this matrix is equal to x2 minus x1 times x3 minus x2 times x3 minus x1. You can see that this is a polynomial of degree 3. No? Because these are homogeneous polynomials. This is degree 1, this is degree 2, this is 1, 0, 1, 2. When you each term in the determinant is homogeneous of degree 3. Is of degree 3. And so the determinant is homogeneous polynomial of degree 3. If you take a computation, then this is very simple to do by now. In general, if you have n by n, what is the determinant? The determinant is the product of all the differences. All the differences.
For example, if you add 4, 1, 4, 4 squared, 4 cubed, etc., it will be x4 minus x3, 4 minus x2, 4 minus x1, x3 minus x2, x3 minus x1, x2 minus x1, and the other will be all the stuff. This is simple to prove by induction, but we just check the degree. In this case, the degree will be 0 if you have 4 rows. 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3. So it will be 6. And actually the terms that I told you were 6. So it is not complicated to prove by induction. Why? Because let us say here, what I can do in order to simplify something here, I can multiply this row by x1 and x2. So this determinant is equal to determinant of 1, 1, 1, x2 minus x1, x3 minus x1. Because x1 minus x1 is 0. Then I multiply by x1 squared. Then I can multiply this by x1 and take the difference. So it will be 0. X two times x two minus x one because I multiply this by x one, and then I have x three minus x two. Okay. Then what I can do? Determinant 1, 1, 1, 0. Then you can see that this can be multiplied by x2 and subtracted from this. And you get 0, 0, x3 minus x2, x3 minus x2. And then you multiply the elements on the diagonal, and you will get this. And you can do this for everything. Of course, you don't need to do, I did all the steps, but you have to, when you do first step, what you can see, that you can have some you are only to prove that you can take some elements and then you can reduce to a random determinant 1 minus 1 or 1 less dimension. It can be done at this moment. Yes, because what is this? If I, what is this? If you, when you do in general, here you have just E1. Here, you, if you take, you put in evidence this term, x2 minus x1, you will get 1, x2, x2 squared, and so on. All powers of x. And here you will get in evidence x3 minus x1, x3, and you will be left with x1, x3, x3 squared, and so on. So when you get all this stuff in evidence, you will get x2 minus x1 times x3 minus x1, and you will get van der Waals matrix with one less dimension, and the determinant will be x3 minus x2. And in general, you will back get all the for each column you will get all the difference xi minus x1, and then you will get the van der Mol matrix here. You will get, after that you will get the van der Mol matrix. When you take this out and this out, you will get the van der Mol matrix with the only x2 and the x3. Okay? And actually this is this is, if xi are the points at which we measure the data way I, and we want to interpolate with some set of parameters with polynomials. No? We use this function. This function, because we use the function with three parameters, ax squared plus bx plus c. You can use other functions. For example, if you want to use a, the exponential of x plus b, what do you have to put? Here you have to put 1, 1, 1, 1. Here you have to put exponential of x1, exponential of x2. Then you have to see if the rank is full in general because of your, but the same applies. If you want to take an approximation with any function, so which are the rules? This is not strictly connected to concerning methods, but which are the rules for approximation of the data? If you want to do something correct, you have to apply two principles. First principle: you should not even this is not you should not derive the type of function from the data. You should have some model. Why I want to apply a parabola, approximate with a parabola here? Because I know from theory that this phenomenon should be quadratic. Okay? Of course, it can happen that you have so many data and you see that they can be fit with some parameter. But remember that this is ambiguous, because you can have many functions that look like parameter. So it's not a good rule to derive the. If you are forced to do it, first of all, try some very simple function, straight line or parabola. And one thing very much forbidden is to use the same number of parameters as the measurements. Because even if polynomials, you know, if I have five interpolation points, if I have five measurements, here. If I get some five polynomials of 5 degrees, I can set the coefficients in order that I can fit perfectly. But this has maybe has no sense, no meaning. There was some famous interpolation of 8 measurements of the word population. No, the measurements were agreed, because the word population is agreed. Then you have something like this, that since the measurements are 7, and you approximate with the polynomial of degree 7, you get something like this. And then the population will, all world will die within 2020 or something. It's not. Understand? parameters usually should be much smaller than the number of measurements. And second, you should have some theory behind to support your data that should say some model that the phenomenon is linear, is quadratic, is exponential, is logarithmic. You can even infer how the function is from your data, but in that case it's not completely forbidden. But then you have to devise a model, and then you have to get confirmation of your model from other data, otherwise you are not doing correct science. Understand? So this is model. Maybe I can get intuition that this phenomenon is quadratic. Okay. Now I start that this phenomenon from this hypothesis, and then I have to get model and explanation to this. But in many cases, the explanation not always can be 100% sure. Take for example some models in medicine. Okay? You have so many factors that you can infer that some correlation between some enzyme and some other stuff is for certain time. But then if this model is true, you have to get confirmation, even statistical confirmation, but from our data. Because this parameter you set for this data in order to could be coincidental. And then you have to remember another thing. This is not strictly connected to matrices, but it's so important that I take every occasion to. You have to remember correlation is not causation. Correlation does not mean causation. Let us say you have some famous example. You know that if you have some yellow fingers, this maybe raises your risk of coronary heart disease by three times it's bigger, or cancer, lung cancer, for 3 times. For example, the red meat has a correlation. They see that people that eat more red meat maybe have 20% more cancer than others. 20% is not. But still, you know, I'm saying, okay, what one people can think? I will not eat red meat, and my risk will go down. It's not sure. Why? If I have yellow fingers, my risk of lung cancer is 3 times as small. So I wash my fingers very carefully. I have not more yellow fingers, and my risk goes down. If I continue to smoke, does not go down. Understand? So the reason is not yellow fingers are not the real cause. They are a proxy for smoke. Since smoke raises your risk of lung cancer 10 times, even if you measure yellow fingers, this can be from smoke and will raise maybe 3 times. Correlation is not causation. Sometimes it can be the other way around. You infer that A implies B, and instead it is B that implies A. But sometimes, these are more tricky, you have that A and B are both proxy from a third cause, C. So you see A, you see B, you see this correlation, and you will tell what is which sense. The inference is completely different. For example, it is very well known that in the 60s there was a 95% correlation between the number of students at the university, actually the number of professors at the university was high, and the number of people suffering from alcohol dependence. And since the number of professors usually is strictly proportional to the number of students, when I did this exercise for students, I thought that this was 95% in student number of students. Then made the jump on that seat because, I just subscribed to study at university. I don't want to get alcohol problems. But why? It's very simple. In the 60s, there was a big development. And development, economic development, brought good things and other things. And they were strictly correlated. Okay? We can